Before the creation, there was void. Before anything came to be, there was nothing. But there was God, and everything existed in God. There are wonders in every aspect of creation, and they are because everything existed in the mind of the wonderful of all beings, the ultimate being, the creator of all. One such simple wonder is the bamboo.
Hey, stop! If you are representing a plant growing that is too fast, don't you think?
Maybe true, but not exactly.
What do you mean?
I mean that bamboo is said to grow to a height of 4 feet in a day.
Wow! That cannot be true. It is too marvelous to be a fact.
By Jove, it is true, and that is the wonder about this bamboo. This bamboo, when it was planted as a seed, showed no sign of shooting up for over 4 years. And this is the 5th year. It has grown to be 90 feet within 2 months.
What? Are you kidding me? 90 feet in 2 months?
Yes, you heard it right. 90 feet. But not in just 2 months, in 4 years and 2 months. Only that, those 4 years, I had to be patient, giving it water and sunshine, my love and undying hope.
Wow! 4 years in preparation. And then the phenomenal growth, the wonder of creation.
Hello there. Was someone speaking about the Auxilium College for Women, Chittampatti?
About Auxilium College?
Yes, 4 years of preparation and a phenomenal growth in just a few months. That's Auxilium Chittampatti.
Oh, that sounds so marvelous, but we are speaking about the bamboo here.
வந்து முனகும் பாடல்களே தூரச்சிகரங்களில் தண்ணீர் துவைக்கும் அருவிகளே.
Yes, that's true. When I see these bamboo trees that stand tall in front of me, they certainly remind me of the miraculous growth of Auxilium Arts and Science College for Women at Chittampatti.
Now you surprise us. How do you see the parallel between these bamboos and the Auxilium College Chittampatti?
Yes. Explain that to us, please.
I shall, with pleasure.
நாளை என்றும் நம் கையில் இல்லை, நாம் யாவும் தேவன் கை பொம்மைகளே என்றால் கூட போராடு நண்பா, என்றைக்கும் தோற்காது உண்மைகளே. உசைன் போல்ட்டை கொள்ளாமல் ஓடு, கோல்டு தேடி வரும் உங்கள் வாழ்வும் வெற்ற
In 2015, a fertile land of 3.5 acres was bought under the leadership of Reverend Sister Magnifica Suse, the then provincial of the undivided province of Chennai, who dreamt of a ministry around the strategic spot on the Tiruchirappalli-Madurai national highways.
The dream.
In 2018, after the bifurcation of the province of Chennai into INM and INT, a few other pieces of adjoining land measuring 3 acres were bought with the aim of starting a college for girls, making the total land area at Chittampatti 6 acres and 39 cents.
The development in silence.
The land remained dormant for the first 4 years after the bifurcation of the province. There was no external sign of growth. But in the mind of God, there was a plan in the making. God had not given up on that land, nor did the provincial sister Amalanathan Mary Margaret.
The patient wait.
Like the first crack in the hard topsoil of the ground, in 2021, the provincial decided to build the first block for college, the current centenary block that was inaugurated on February 13, 2022.
The first signs of sprouting.
On March 19, 2022, on the solemnity of Saint Joseph, the task of documentation and acquiring the needed recognition to begin the Arts and Science College for Women was officially handed over to Sister Vedamuthu Savari, who was identified as the right person for the Himalayan task of getting the college in place and going.
The right resource.
Like the Chinese bamboo tree that shoot to a tremendous height within a few months, the growth of the college has been a marvel, a miracle, a wonder. In just 3 months, the government order to begin the college was received in June 2022, and the affiliation to Madurai Kamaraj University was obtained in August 2022.
God, that's awesome and certainly a miracle. But I know it does not happen just like that. Who were the ones behind this?
Absolutely. There were these who were behind everything.
What a heavenly sight! But you have reasons for all these tall claims, I am certain, don't you?
Yes, of course. Let our dear heavenly hosts speak for themselves.
Let me begin. I have a great love for the mission at Chittampatti, and I am continuously interceding for you all. Did you notice that the process for initiating the new mission began on my day, March 19th, 2022, and the letter of intent to begin the process of opening the Arts and Science College for Women at Chittampatti was sent on March 30th, 2022, again a Wednesday, my day. And what about the first inspection from the Directorate of Collegiate Education, Chennai? That was April 19, 2022, the 19th, my day. Finally, the affiliation order. That was formally signed by the Vice Chancellor and Registrar on Wednesday, August 3, 2022.
That is so sweet, isn't it? I wish to express my love too for these young girls and for my daughters who are working for them. Incidentally, the government order by the Minister of Higher Education and other appropriate officials was signed on June 24, 2022. 24th is my dear day, isn't it?
My mother, that was my day too that year. June 24 was the solemnity of the Sacred Heart. To continue, the inspection committee from Madurai Kamaraj University made an official inspection for affiliation with university on July 8, 2022, and that was a Friday.
Oh, certainly, I'm aware of that. And additionally, the college was open with a solemn ceremony on August 24, 2022, and the first historic batch of Auxilium Arts and Science College for Women at Chittampatti Madurai was given a warm welcome as the centenary batch to mark the 100 years of FMA presence in India on that 24th.
How beautiful to hear all these.
Yes, it is. And this mission has already become a blessing to hundreds of young girls, especially the poor and the needy, with the charism of Don Bosco and Mother Mazzarello illumining their lives.
Yes, it is true. The simple bamboos have now become a home and a dome of learning and education for young women.
Currently, we have 5 departments that include BA English, BSc Maths, BSc Computer Science, BCom CA, and BBA, and a total of 45 students studying in our college. Like the Chinese bamboo that develops its strong roots to survive in future, so the Lord is preparing a solid foundation, and we shall see in the near future the multitude of students enlivening themselves in this home of learning.
Bamboos remind us of another phase of this college mission.
And what is that?
The hollowness that is there in the bamboo makes it possible to sculpt it into a flute, and with the passing of the wind, it makes such a melodious music. That is how the simplicity of this mission, the simplicity of this college, becomes the possibility of sculpting it into a marvelous flute to make an unending melody of praise and thanks to the Lord.
Women pursuing higher education here become instruments to end the gender divide in the society. Apart from the degrees they obtain, the education they receive to become confident, the holistic formation with all the extracurricular activities, the training to express their minds, and the lifestyle in the college, working in collaboration with the management, staff, and fellow students, these make them game changers in their own contexts. This is the melodious symphony that we just heard. The melody of a woman living her life to the full. As a woman of strength and character, a woman of light and faith, a woman of hope and love for the entire humanity and the universe. Auxilium Arts and Science College for Women envisions a future
that provides hope to thousands of poor young girls, making them self-reliant and agents of social transformation in today's situation.
It promotes women of great hope.
We are women and we have immense potential. It may appear that our progress is slow, but our strength is our endurance and our character is manifest in our patience. And there will be a day our hard work and persistence will bring light to our dreams. We are women of light and faith.
We are women and we will not give up in our situations of trials and difficulties. We keep working on ourselves and our strength and character will ultimately make us emerge as the life-giving force of the entire humanity. And we form here to live our life to the full. Come what may, we are women, signs of fullness and signs of life.
Yes, we are women and we are born to endure and to achieve. We are epitomes of love and compassion. All the struggles and difficulties that come our way make us strong and resilient because they are tempered by love into an undaunted spirit of a life-giving force. We are women and we are signs of God's undying love.